Hi, good afternoon to everybody. Thank you to be here. I hope I can, after lunch, usually we are a little sleepy. I will try to explain some things that can make you think a little bit about our industry, where the industry in India as well, and how the industry is evolving, how we are adapting to the changes in the world, and what we are proposing for getting this challenge. Just a moment to understand how it works. Okay. The gene before Stefano was explaining a nice history about the starting in India and how the things were moving. To me, there is a clear change in the blue gene from the moment we pass from some garments that were mainly for workwear, so they had to be strong, they had to be resistible and resistant, also comfortable for working. It arrived a point when they had been converted in something related more to fashion. So to get this fashion, there were some transformers. It means some elements who helped pass from workwear to fashion wear. These were basically the water, the chemicals, the creativity of the people, and the hand skill of the operators. Because of them, we got garments with an attractive look, that they were comfortable to wear again. There was the introduction of the brand concept. It means that the people wanted a particular brand because they were representing an attitude in front of the life. And also it was important the differentiation. We never wanted to go same of our neighbor. So in this part, what was important was at the beginning the fabric, the stitching, the tailoring, the measurements. Then in the fashion, it was the laundry, the R&D, and the marketing. And the key factors to get them were the dry process, the washing machines, and the standardization of these processes. Especially in the last, I would say, 10 to 15 years, we are really in a world that is changing dramatically and very fast. The world is changing because of internet, for sure. This entered into our life and this is changing everything, but also there is a big growth in all the Asian countries that is increasing a lot the consumption of products. There is starting also the people starts being conscious about the environment. It means we cannot destroy the planet. We have only one. We are in a society where if I cannot spend, I'm not happy. And all this is happening at a very, very high speed. For sure, all these changes are also having a big impact in the fashion. It means that today there is the fashion is much more global. When I started visiting India 20 years back, hardly you can find any single person wearing jeans, and today you see many people, although there is a big scope for growing. To me, it's very important the idea of I want now. It means this is Amazon. This is I see something and I want at that particular time. We can compare product and price very simply. Internet is giving us all these tools. There is a big price pressure, okay? It means that if I can get the same level of product and I can pay less, I will do. The demand has increased. Although the textile people always we are lamenting that we are in a difficult business, in a difficult sector, the reality is that the global consumption of apparel is growing. And of course, every time more, there are more environment restrictions that are making, sorry, that are making the things more difficult in terms of manufacturing and much better for the environment, for the planet. So with all these changes, we require speed. To me, the word today is speed. This is the most important part. You may have a very nice product, but if you are not fast in delivering to the people at the moment that they want, we lose. We lose the order, we lose the brand, we lose everything. There is, we need to use really the data that we have from the consumers. It means we are in the IT world where we have so many data about what my customer wants. But the reality is that we are using late. In the fashion industry, we are today using late. We need to wait the manufacturing to get the garments in the shop, and then we start taking this data and analyzing and changing for the new collection. The reality that is this is late. We need to have all this much more faster. We need organizations very, very fast also. Everything is related to speed. We need organizations who can or who can change the way of doing, the way of manufacturing, designing according to what the customer wants. A lot of creativity, for sure, delivering new products always, and we need to produce this in a sustainable way. So, we are coming from a moment where the industry was the center, so it means that the consumer were buying whatever the industry was manufacturing. So it was more simple for the industry. We are going to a world where the consumer is the center. The consumer, his finger, and the click in the internet. And this is the center. So the industry has to change. We cannot think in industries that are ready for making long serial of big volumes of the same style, everybody same, but we need to think in an industry that can adapt to the exact requirement of each customer located around the world. So we need to transform in the industry the creation process, adapting to the customer's demand. We need to adapt in the production system, in the marketing, as before Stefano was explaining, and in the distribution. This is also very important. When we think in our industry, in R&D, we only think in product development. R&D is much more. We need to create new processes, new ways to reach the customers, and we need the speed to execute them. So what we need to achieve is a product with some features. We need the high fashion. We need to deliver continuously proposals to the market. We need low cost. We cannot, in general, we cannot manufacture thinking that the money of our buyers is unlimited. We need the respect for the environment. We need the respect for the workers. The time to market has to be as short as possible, and also it has to be profitable for the manufacturers and for the brands. And the way to do that is standardization and systematization of unique styles. It means one single style to be able to cover as maximum the maximum needs of our customers. The use of the market intelligence, it means the use of the feedback from the market in the real time, reducing process to reduce time, logistics, and cost. And then we need different type of people in our industry. We need what we call technocrats. We need a mixture between technologists, people who love the technology, and people who has the artistic part, so that we combine in the same process. So to do that, the technology is the center of the new jeans finish today. And this is a reality. I would say that India is in the track, but probably is not a pioneer as it had been in many other sectors. I think that, that India has a lot of potential to be also leader in all this transformation, but requires this change and requires now, especially because of the domestic environment where there are so many brands, so many customers to reach, and it's required to make this transformation fast. This is another small video about how we understand the designing. The designing is not anymore to have 100 designers thinking every day new models, but to standardize and to make some processes that can be reproduced and changing according to the customer needs in a fast way. A minute. This is what we call one design unlimited possibilities, because from a single concept we can develop a full range of designs, of product. Sorry, there was some music to make this more, but it's not there. So we start with a concept like this, and from this concept we can develop a full range of products. So we take from the same feed, then we take some of the ideas, some of the concepts, and we can just, you know, cut and this is making the things much more faster and much more easy, because it allows also to release short series of garments, so, some styles that maybe are more risky, but making in shorter volumes. And according to the market requirement, as the manufacturing is so fast, we can adapt according to the sales, how the sales are going. So from one single product with some particular washes, we can establish three, four different range of washes, and then modify from the same concept, that in this case is the patchwork effect, we can create a full range of garments in an easy way. I think that this is just one idea, but it's something that, especially for all the people I see here, different people involved in brands, I think that these concepts are very interesting in order to gain this speed and to use the information from the market. So this is, I will go fast, but just to understand how the technology may help, in the left hand you have a traditional process for one basic style, that it could be a medium fading garment, where you have a process for a traditional way that is approximately 22 steps, while by the use of the technology we can reduce this into 12 steps. So it means that the for sure that the speed is faster, the time for the production is lower, we have less possibilities of fail because everything is much more standard, and for sure also we have a reduction in the environment impact. Now, when we compare the two processes here, we can see that the total time for the manufacturing, we have decreased in nearly 50%. Which is very important in terms of costing and handling the operations, but also if you see the water, we passed from 50 to 60 liters to approximately 10 liters. So this is what the technology is giving. It's giving us the possibility to increase the design possibilities that cannot be done with hand, The quality is much more consistent. The price, we can optimize our production cost. The lead time is reduced because of the process time, but also there is not rejections, not second qualities, not reoperations. Compliance, we are eliminating the hazard processes so that people and environment are more safe, and we use less natural resources, which is very important in countries where, with especially countries like India, with a big growth in population. So now the point is, let's do, let's start, let's put this in motion. We need to act on the creation by let's say, receiving the fashion trends, the customer behavior, analyzing the production and the forecast for the sales. Let's take all this information so that we can produce accordingly to that. Let's make the production more standard, and then let's redesign the distribution. When we think in India, we have the A cities, the B cities, the C cities. This is easy to deliver. But we have a lot of population that is not having access to the normal shops. Let's think. No, we cannot be in the same place and thinking that everything will keep in the same way. Let's think, let's redesign how we make delivering to our customers. All this process is starting from what we call the smart lab, or the designing process is not starting today with a pencil, and it's starting also with the technology, where we analyze the fabric so that we know that fabric, which processes are better for it. For instance, there are fabrics that are very good when you want to do a raw denim, but some fabrics are very good when we want to do a heavy bleached denim. So let's start first the fabric. Let's convert the fabrics in a way that are making the process more efficient. So the idea is that the manufacturers every time more are starting doing this process, so that once they have the process settled by the use of the technologies, then it's just to pass from the lab to the bulk, instead of going with so many trials and addition and so we try every fabric, we try the different designs, and then we can arrive at the final product. And this is a continuous process. It's not only when we have to start a new collection, but this is a process that we have to be doing continuously so that we are ready to deliver what the customer wants. Then we pass simply from our development center at the development team into the bulk production. This is allowing us also to adapt our manufacturing place and our designing place differently. For instance, here there are some of the manufacturers that are delivering their goods in other parts of the world. Why don't allocate their R&D near their customers, for instance? Now there is the possibility.
Wait, didn't add it. सर वो यार प्रिपेयर कर रहा हूँ सर नहीं ठीक है
एंड दिस इज द न्यू मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट वेयर वी हैव द स्टिचिंग फ्रॉम द स्टिचिंग वी आर गोइंग टू द लेजर वेयर वी give the all the value addition, the dry process, the traditional dry process made by the machine. We substitute the traditional desizing process by with a much more efficient process called Priozonic. We can even recycle online all the water used for the process so that the consumption of the water is really, really very low. And then we apply the chemicals through nanobubbles, what we call the e-flow. So this is a process much more simple as compared to the traditional, but also giving much more designing possibilities. Here I want to add a small remark about sustainability. Sustainability is important, it's very important for our future, but also for our cost. If we use more and more resources, the cost always are going up, up, up. So in the last few years, there had been many talks about what sustainability means. What is a sustainable gene? And there is some kind of consensus where we can say that sustainable finishes are more sustainable, more efficient in production because they are shorter. It is also important to understand that solutions that increasing the cost are not sustainable. It means it can be a very sustainable solution, but if this is more expensive, the market will not accept. So our effort and our duty is to create garments that are sustainable and at least at a neutral cost. It means same cost as normal. Otherwise, it will not be in the market. Of course, to create this requires capital investment. It's a transformation, so it requires capital investment, which has to be recovered with the production. And just a point that is important also, that according to some studies, approximately 5,000 small to medium laundries will disappear in the next 3 years worldwide. These are some previsions. Why? Because they will not adapt to the adoption of the technology. Is adapting to that or dying in the way. So in parameters, what is sustainable? A gin with a maximum 30 liters of water. Now this is sustainable. In a short time, this will be a must. With 2 kilowatt per hour of energy, eliminating 11 chemical products that of the detox list about very hazardous chemicals, and especially to remove potassium permanganate in any kind of application, sandblast and formaldehyde resins. This is important because this is today one of the remaining activities in the genes manufacturing, which is really harmful, and that is now under study in the European Union to be banned. And there are some indications that it may be banned in a very short time. This kind of not only the PP, but any activity that is harmful for the people or harmful for the environment, I think that is our responsibility as Denim people to work to eliminate. Because we are, in the Denim, we are rebel, but we don't want to be criminal. It means we like jeans, we like what genes means, but this doesn't—it doesn't mean that we are killing the people and the environment. We, at least, we have to be proud about our sector. And during many years, if somebody is asking you, "Where are you? What are you doing? What are you working?" Sometimes we were little, you know, it was not nice to say, "I'm in Denim." They said, "Denim is killing people." So let's change this and let's make a Denim sustainable, nice, rebel, but not criminal. So from all the different things, from the summary, I would talk again about the speed. To me, speed is becoming the key. So any action we take in our industry to increase the speed to the market, it will be successful. Whatever thing is going against the speed, believe me, is going to disappear. So this is to me one of the main ideas that I would like to remark. So we need time savings, inventory savings, environmental savings, and manufacturing savings. So at the end, this is a speed. If we want to be competitive, we have to have a speed. We need to pass from this view, from this picture, to that picture. This has to be our industry. Okay. Thank you so much for your attention.